Today we're talking go-to Chironomid fishing setup for still waters on this episode of Fly Fish University TV. Hello everybody and welcome back. The time has come for another episode of Q&A. Friday, one of my favorite times of the week. I just want to say thanks to each and every person who made it out to the Fly Fishing Accelerator Workshop. It was such a neat virtual event. We had almost 500 registrants from all around the world, and I want to welcome all of our founding members that we were able to bring into the Fly Fish University coaching program. Honestly, the past year has been, there's been so obviously so many ups and downs. But one of the big ups has been able to continue the love that I have for teaching people how to make fly fishing a better experience so incredibly possible with the use of the internet and these amazing platforms that we have like Zoom and our course creation platforms and so on. So anyways, today's question comes from Steve in Vancouver, BC, and he says, I'm really curious to know your go-to setup for fishing chironomids on still waters. Well, you're in luck because I got it sitting right in front of me here and you're gonna notice it's folded in half. That's because that's how it sits in my rod tube. A quick personal thing. I actually never take my rods down other than at the very end of the year. I always leave them folded in half because I like to get to the lake, pull them out of the case and fish, okay? So anyways, I'm just gonna give you a quick breakdown of precisely what I use, why I use it, and we're gonna start with the rod. So the rod that I fish primarily for chironomid fishing, I fish this 9.5 foot six weight. This is a Scott Flex. I've fished Scott rods for a very long time. They are my favorite. Some would say that they are the bomb. And I have fished them since I was about 17 years old. One of my first nice rod I ever got was a Scott S4. And I had sold it years after that, but these are great, great rods. And the reason why I fish this rod is because it's not an ultra fast rod. I actually like that these rods are a little bit, you know, more in kind of the moderate fast because it allows me to open up my loop. You know, when I'm roll casting with really long leaders, it allows me to keep my loop open. But what I love about it is it allows me to protect my tippet a little bit more so I can fish, you know, 6 pound tests for really big fish and still land them super quick, not worry about breaking very many fish off. So again, that's a 9.5 foot six weight. Another dimension that I really love is a 10 foot five weight, which I've got in the same model as well. But really, really good lake rods. We fish them, you know, fish them all the time. They're short enough and powerful enough to fish a sinking line. Especially in windy conditions, but I really do enjoy them for chironomid fishing. So the reel that I use, I've had these actually since I started my guiding company, which I no longer do a lot of that, but quick shout out to the boys at Interior Fly Fishing Company. So I actually started using these when I started my guiding company in 2017. And this is a Ross Cimarron 2. These have actually been discontinued since, but I really like them. There's something about them. The auditory on them, you know, they're from an auditory perspective, very appealing. I really like the ability to spin, you know, on the incoming really quickly to get line into the boat, you know, especially if it's sitting on the floor of the boat, get it up onto the reel as quick as I can. I really enjoy fighting fish from the reel. It is a disc drag reel. It's a kind of a mid to large arbor, you know, it's definitely not a small arbor reel by any means, but they're a beautiful little reel. They're not terribly expensive. If you can find one, you know, I know that they don't make them anymore, but if you can find one, they're definitely worth your money. They're really a great setup. So then moving from there, you can see I've got some blue backing on here. That's, I don't know, kind of just like a trendy thing. I'm actually not sure why I put blue backing on here, but about 100 yards of 20 pound Dacron backing. And then we're looking at Scientific Angler's Amplitude Smooth Stillwater Indicator. This is a great line. I like it because it's high vis, you know, it's high vis on the tip. So basically we've got some alternating optic green and orange pieces at the end. So if I'm naked line fishing, you know, I can kind of watch the tip of the line. nice, really, really nice feature. Now, I'm gonna show you here off the end of this, okay? So now we're getting into the line and leader section here. I've shared this many times before, but I actually don't use tapered leaders when I'm chironomid fishing. Okay, so chironomid fishing, I actually prefer big time to use just a level pieces of fluorocarbon. So what I have is just 3X Scientific Angler's absolute tippet, absolute fluorocarbon all the way down from my fly line to my barrel swivel, which I'll talk about in a second. But it's one thing that's really important to note is what I do use is a little bumper here. And what this is actually 12 or 15 pound test. You can use monofilament, you can use fluorocarbon. But what this is a short piece of tippet and it's got two perfection loops tied in it. It's as short as I can really make it. In total, it's only about 4 inches long. The reason that I do this is to act as a stopper between the fly line and that thin tippet material. When I'm running a level leader, you don't really want to be running that thin stuff right to your fly line because you can shred the coating of the fly line really easily, can actually waterlog the line over time. So I'll use that short piece of heavy mono or heavy fluoro just to connect those two. So going into the leader, again, really basic, like 3X tippet all the way from the fly line down to a barrel swivel. Now I'll use a short barrel swivel. Typically if I'm fishing deeper water, what this does is just kind of helps the fly get down and stay down. If I'm fishing shallow water, less than 10 feet deep, I really don't worry too much about it. But in deeper water, it does help the fly get down a little bit quicker. Originally, I think these were used to separate monofilament and fluorocarbon. Some people might be wondering why would I use fluorocarbon all the way through the leader, and that's because I think it sinks, well, it does, sinks faster, and I really like the way that the level leader just hangs straight up and down. Okay, again, you'll see I've got a Phil Rolly style quick release indicator pegged on here. I actually rigged these upside down with the thick end of the peg facing down towards the swivel. The reason for that is so that this thick end of the peg acts like a stopper. So it's gonna hit that swivel and it's gonna stop, which is nice because otherwise it's gonna slide down off the end of the fly and into the water. So rigging those upside down actually keeps your indicator on your leader better. So I've got that down to my barrel swivel. I've got some 4X Scientific Angler's absolute fluorocarbon below there. I'm using anytime I'm doing any interconnecting in my leader, I'm usually using a blood knot or a double surgeon's knot. Then I've got an improved clinch on one side of my swivel, improved clinch on the other side of the swivel, and I've got about 20, this one's got probably 22 inches, maybe 24 inches of that 4X fluorocarbon down to my fly. The fly is still looking pretty good, and I'm using a non-slip mono loop to attach the fly. That just lets the fly kind of hang, you know, a little bit more free. I really only suggest using a loop knot, like the non-slip mono loop or a Duncan loop to attach the fly when you're chironomid fishing because it just lets it hang way nicer. So that's my go-to chironomid fishing setup. I'm excited to get my hands on some new rods here, but this is really nice. I think, you know, I lean a little bit more towards the 10-foot 5-weight. Or even the 9.5 foot 5-weight or the 9.5 foot 6-weight, which is what this is here. A little bit longer rod is nice, lets you turn over indicators, long leaders, makes it a whole lot easier. So I hope that this was helpful. And if you're interested in stillwater fishing, okay, my friend Phil Rowley and I, as most of you probably know, have a joint venture called the Stillwater Fly Fishing Academy. If you wanna make the most of the ice off window, which is some of the best fishing of the year, if you know how to time it right, if you know how to fish it, you can go to stillwaterflyfishingacademy.com. We've actually got a free three-part video training that's coming up in a couple weeks. And it's the ice off stillwater tactics. It's a little mini course. It's just designed to teach you how to maximize your results in the ice off window. So you can go to stillwaterflyfishingacademy.com. I'll leave a link down below. If you're listening to this, then I'll leave a link in the show notes. And I think it's gonna help you a lot. Doesn't cost you anything and it's gonna be a great time. So thank you guys so much. And I hope to see you on the water sometime this year because the weather's nice, it's springtime, and stillwater season is upon us. Thank you so much.